عبده والصلاة القائمة محمد رضيته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. نشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله الأمين ورحمته للعالمين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله العظيم ولزوم طاعته، أحذركم ونفسي عن عصيانه ومخالفة أمره. قال تعالى: من عمل صالحاً فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها وما ربك بظلام للعبيد. العاقل من اشتغل بعيوبه عن عيوب غيره، والسعيد من وفقه الله. وفقني الله وإياكم لما يحبه ويرضاه. عباد الله، I began by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I simply said what to commonly say. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah, God Almighty, the Creator, whom we praise, from whom we seek guidance and help, to whom we turn for forgiveness, to whom we seek His blessings and all what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us. That we bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except God Almighty, the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a messenger and a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has been sent, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, as a mercy. That as usual, we remind ourselves before we remind anyone of us that we become mindful of Allah, become conscious of Allah. This is the word that is taqwa, that's being used commonly. Frequently you hear this from the member, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullaha haqqa tuqatihi wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullaha wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat ligad. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum a'malakum yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep ya ayyuha alnas inna اتقوا ربكم الله الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها بث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. All these verses that repeatedly you hear them revolve around the word taqwa. Being mindful of Allah, being conscious of Allah, protect ourselves from anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to protect ourselves from it. And whoever does good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we remind ourselves, and I said, usi nafsi, we start by myself, that we fear Allah and be mindful of Him, and that we have to worry most about our own shortcomings, our weaknesses, rather than weaknesses of others. This is why our scholars say, al-aqil, the wisest among us, he or she is more concerned about ourselves rather than others. And those of us who are guided by Allah, God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a lot of blessings for them. Now, I came from Canada and I'm here for a conference on education. There are two things that came to my mind when I was actually thinking of coming here. One of them is to give you something Canadian. I know that you are here frequently, you hear the khutbas and so on. Recently, we had a conference, and the title of, actually the theme of the conference was the Alliance of Virtue. Alliance of Virtue. Alliance is Hilf in Arabic language, and versus Fudul. This is the alliance that the Prophet والسلام, witnessed, actually when he was only 20 years of age, and even well before he received revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the significance of it is that after the Prophet والسلام, received his revelation, he actually mentioned that incident or that what we call alliance that was signed at him. He says, according to the narration of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, قال شهدت حلف المطيبين من عمومتي. Like I witnessed this beautiful alliance of my own uncles and cousins. وأنا غلام. I was a young man. فما أحب أن لي حمر النعم وإني أنكثر. This is what the Prophet later on said, and I'll tell you why, what the theme of the conference, what is the significance of it, what's the importance of this alliance of virtue that we are going to talk about. Now in another narration, which is more important than the first one, the Prophet said, لغشهدت في دار عبد الله بن جدعان. Abdullah ibn جدعان was the man in whose house this alliance was held. And it was something that signed by them. I'll tell you the story later on. He said, Abdullah ibn Jud'an, حِلْفًا مَا أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ بِهِ مِنْ حُمُرِ النِّعَمِ وَلَوْ دُعِيتُ لَهُ فِي الْإِسْلَامُ لَأَجَبْتُ. The Prophet والسلام, said, when this alliance which was held in the house of this man by the name Abdullah ibn Jud'an, and the Prophet attended, was his young, he said, if this alliance is brought together again and people want to sign me for it, I will sign for that. Now what is this? An incident happened. You know, the Arabs were in turmoil, just like with the turmoil that we are here now, a lot of killing, a lot of bloodshed. And there was a war that raged for a long period of time. They call it Harb al-Fijar or Harb al-Fujar. Both of them are used of them. After that war settled down, people were a little bit in that state of, like, everybody's very apprehensive. Anything can trigger people to do something. They said a man from a tribe in Yemen, his name is Zayd, came to Mecca, so that he has some merchandise, he wants to sell it. And during those days, they used to say that if you are strong, you eat the weak. So there is no place for weak people. Anyone can take people for granted. So a man, another person by the name Al-As ibn Wail, they said he approached this man, and he wanted to make a deal to buy his merchandise. So the man made a deal with him, but when he got hold of the merchandise, he said to him, just disappear off my face. I'm not going to give you anything. So the man was stunned. So he went in the Kaaba at that time, and he started calling on the Arab tribes, on the different tribes in Quraysh, to come and rescue him and help him. He said nobody responded to him. So one of the cousins of the Prophet والسلام, by the name of Zubair ibn Abd al-Muttalib, passed by, and he heard this man screaming that he has been unjustly treated, people took his things. This man just openly said to him, I take it, you have nothing to do with me. So he said, this man went to this Abdullah ibn Jun'ani's house, and he said to him, Wallahi ma hada matruk, by Allah, we can't leave this to be like that. And at that time, actually, they said it was the month of Muharram. You know, this was a sacred month. And people gathered in this house of Jud'an, and they decided in that they have to sign an alliance. And the alliance will be this way, that no one who is being unjustly treated or a person who is oppressor to be in Mecca. So they decided to take right for everyone, no matter who that person is. So the major tribe at that time was Quraysh. So they started gathering together, and they came and signed this alliance. Now Ibn Zubair himself summarized it by saying, قَالَ إِنَّ الْفُضُولَ تَعَاهَدُوا تَوَافَدُوا وَتَعَاهَدُوا, like they came together, وَتَعَاقَدُوا أَلَّا يُقِيمَ بِبَطْنِ مَكَّةَ ظَالِمٍ. They said, they gathered together, they sat together, they put their hands together, and they said, no oppressor should be in Mecca. No one should be treating people unjust. أَمْرٌ عَلَيْهِ تَعَاقَدُوا وَتَحَالَفُوا فَالْجَارُ وَالْمُعْتَرُ فِيهَا سَالِمٌ. Like in poetry, in poetic ways, he said that any neighbor, any person who has anything to do, then we have to stand and support for him. So they went to this man while, pulled out the merchandise, gave it to the man that they said that he has it. Now the Prophet والسلام, witnessed this. And he said, what he said later on, that I was a witness for this, and that what came to him. Now, what do we benefit from this, or what was our conference about it? In today's world, when we live, there is a lot of injustices, a lot of oppression, but there are a lot of good people in every nation, every group, every religion, and so on. And one of the things that you could do is to build alliances with these people of virtue, so that people can do the good things together. And there are so many other bases that, like this in the Quran. For instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is, I understand that we have some guests with us here, and I'm going to quote directly the Quran that people don't quote for people over here. On principle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to all humans, to every human being, he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ, stage one, لِتَعَارُفُ. That Allah says, O people, to everyone, that he created us from nations, tribes, groups, whatever it is, he said, so that you can come together and know each other. So there is no barrier, no restriction for anyone to know people, to introduce yourself to them, to know who they are, they know who you are. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revolted. He said in the Quran, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Similar to what this alliance was formed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you can join hands with any people of goodness to promote goodness and to prohibit evil or bad deeds. There is no restriction for a person to do that. And there is no religion, no barrier, no race, nothing that can come between Muslims and others so that they can put their hands together. This is why I have been a principal in a school for about 17 years. I used always to tell the parents, join the parents' committees, join anything that promotes good. And even some mothers used to complain to me about what happens on obscenity of TV. I said there is an organization which is established by Christian churches, by Jewish groups, to go and against these things so that they can purify our houses, give up that one. There is absolutely no restriction for a person to do that. Not only this, the Quran goes further to say the following. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهِ. لَا يَنْهَاكُمْ literally means Allah will not stop you from. Quote, لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَلَّ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. These are the words of Allah. He said, Allah will not at all stop you from who? People who do not mock your religion, people who don't drive you out of your homes, people who don't put you down, people who don't create problems to you, that you exercise what is called birr with them. And the word birr is much more than what you think, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used it, the relationship that a child should have with good parents and parents have their children is called alaqatul birr. And this is why it says even that much of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says you can deal with people in that level. And this is why, alhamdulillah, I said in Canada, we really build those alliances with people. And you can see it. I mean, with all what you have are going through here, the bashing of Muslims, we had a government worse than what is going these days in your election campaigns, you know, this harbor. And he came head on against Muslims, actually against everyone, against the scholars, against Muslims. And there was a treaty that was signed by 450 professors from the top universities in Canada against the man. And people joined hand for that. It was a campaign organized by all our imams, by all the people that we have. And alhamdulillah, the people removed him from power. Who came in? Now, you know, in Canada, we have Justin Trudeau, an amazing man, amazing man. He comes to Muslim conferences. He made it clear, as he keeps repeating, Canadian is a Canadian is a Canadian. It doesn't matter what race, it doesn't matter what color. And even his Minister of Defense, by the way, is a Sikh. He wears a turban. And one person actually tried to mock him and made a joke about him. They removed him completely from that. Why? Because these countries, people should come as they are. By the way, this attire I have is my Sudanese attire. I feel comfortable when I come to California and see this nice weather to go like this. In Canada, you cannot go like this. You have to wait for the summer and hot summer day so that you can get it. So people feel comfortable. People pulled women's like scarves and so on. And the Prime Minister of Canada stands up to say, even in his, what we call, when he became the Prime Minister, in his inaugural speech, that a lady came to him with a child. She said she wants her son or her daughter to live as she wants, to dress as she wants. And the man said that is what he wants to do, and so on. Now, because of this, we felt that this is the time that we bring back, especially to our younger generations. I am a teacher all my life. And we are concerned about our children, because now, and one of the things actually this conference, the education forum that we came for, is basically about authenticity of knowledge, authenticity of administration, authenticity of leadership. These are the themes that are being discussed right now when I'm here. Actually, we have just came from a couple of sessions for them. Why? Because now we have a lot of bombardment, a lot of misinformation, a lot of bashing against people, against things, and then our children get caught in it. We have so many young children. They get hyped by what is happening. They talk to you about injustices that happen. They see all this. But we need really to streamline them and to educate them the proper way. And this is public education. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who said it. And particularly the part that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam emphasized when he said, وَلَوْ تُعِيدُ إِلَىٰ ذَلِكَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ. Yeah, he didn't say, I just attended when I was a young man, but he said, if this alliance is being signed today, I would be signing it. And this word he used, حَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ حَمْرِ النِّعْمِ, this is the word that normally it's a phrase that you, when somebody says to you, this is حَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ حَمْرِ النِّعْمِ, this is more beautiful for me or dearer to me than the best of luxuries in wear it, to mean that this is so valuable to a person that our Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad has it. These are the things that we are trying to project. These are the things that we need Muslims really to learn from them. The reason being is that now, as a Muslim community, whether here in the United States or in Canada or in Britain, alhamdulillah, I've traveled to all these Muslim minority countries, from Australia to New Zealand and so on. You have a fraction of people in Muslims, and they need to live with other people, need to work with other people, and if you are comfortable with religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear, even to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him, if you deal with other people, say exactly this. قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ. We believe in the book that Allah has revealed for us. We believe in everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed for us. All the narrations, we believe this truth, and just made actually something about the synthesis of knowledge. I said the word that Allah used in the Quran is haq. Allahu alladhi anzal al-kitaba bil-haq wal-mizan. We have no doubt about that. But there are other people who differ with us. So what the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says for this, he says, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ. We believe in what Allah revealed in all the books, what Allah revealed to Moses, what he revealed to Jesus Christ alayhi salam, and then what came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. And we are instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use justice to everyone. Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum. If we worship the same God, Almighty, the Creator, He created us and created you. But where we differ, lana a'maluna wa lakum a'malukum. The way we express our love for God, the way we worship God, might be different from yours. Lana a'maluna wa lakum a'malukum. Now, where the difference, the real judgment would be, Allahu yajma'u baynana. On the day of judgment, we are all going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty. And Allah is the one who is going to decide who is one, who is not. This is why we tell our children, you can have friends, you can have good neighbors, you can have good workers, you can have this, you can have this, but you have your own way and so on. We don't get indulged in what people do, and we don't. We say what we see, we believe in it, and we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, and ultimately Allah will resolve this. That God Almighty is the one, as Allah told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum, lana a'maluna wa lakum a'malukum, Allahu yajma'u baynana wa ilayhin masir. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, inshallah, all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the best. And may Allah make us live in peace with other people who want to live in peace as well. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it to all of us, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. Again I said, I praise Allah and I use the word الأحد الصمد, the only one to be worshipped, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who sustained himself by himself, that there is no one who is matching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or even closer to Allah in any way, because this is what we say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ahad and samad for that. Again, we repeat, we bear witness, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is prophet and his messenger. Now, in the second khutbah, all the time I used to narrate something for us to benefit from it so that we can remember it. What came to my mind is a beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the narration of the Prophet, when he gives advice to the companions, that he used to say all the time three things. Some of us scholars call them الثلاثيات. You find a number of the hadith narration of the Prophet, they say ثلاث. So in one of them that was gathered in different places, you get them in books of hadith. But this hadith was put together by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal in one narration. He said, ثلاث مهلكات وثلاث منجيات وثلاث كفارات وثلاث درجات. These are 12. Three sets of each. I'm going to say them quickly without comments on them. He said, فأما المهلكات فشح مطاع وهوى متبع وإعجاب المرء بنفسه. The thing that destroy a Muslim are three. شح is miserliness, stinginess of time, of wealth and so on. It's very destructive to a Muslim. شح وهوى, following your desires. That's why Allah said in the Quran, فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. What's the result? فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. So to be able to restrain our desires, our bad habits about this thing. The third that destroys peace, he says false pride. إِعْجَابُ الْمَرْءِ بِنَفْسِهِ. that we humble ourselves. Allah, the Prophet said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tawadu, be humble, humble yourself, be moderate in everything. These are the three that destroy a Muslim. Against them, the Prophet said, وَثَلَاثٌ مُنَجِّيَاتٌ مُنْجِيَاتٌ. Three actually save us. One, he said, خَشْيَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ. That you become mindful of Allah, whether you are in private or in public. Your secret and public life should be the same. Because with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing can be hidden. Now, the second he said, خَشْيَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ الْقَصْدُ فِي الْفَقْرِ وَالْغِنَى. That you become moderate, whether extreme rich or extremely poor. Moderation is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to live by. The third, which is savior for us, he said, وَالْعَدْلُ فِي الْغَضَبِ وَالْرِضَى. That you become just, whether you are angry with a person, whether you are with your enemy, whether you are his friend, justice is justice. And Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. No matter what is between you and another person, when it comes to justice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you have to exercise it. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam said, this will save a Muslim all the time. Al-adl fil qadbi wal-rida. These are the second three that save us. Quickly, the three that actually the Prophet said, وَثَلَاثٌ كَفَّارَةٌ. Things that wipe our sins. And they're very simple. The Prophet used to give practical things for us. He said, فَأَمَّا. The thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam says, wipe our sins. He said, فَسْبَاقُ الْمُدُوءِ عَلَى الْمَكَارِهِ وَانْتِظَارُ الصَّلَاةِ بَعْدَ الصَّلَاةِ وَنَقْلُ الْأَقْدَامِ إِلَى الْجَمَاعَاتِ. Three things. One, he said, you maintain your wudu. The Prophet in another hadith, your ablution. Because you are always remembering Allah. You break your wudu, you go and make wudu. Keep it. And he said, man hafiz wudu'ahu faqad amin. Very simple. That if you keep your wudu, it reminds you all the time of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a way of purity for yourself, for your physique, for your heart. That's number one. Number two, he said, intizaru salati ba'du salah. That our mindset should be on our prayer times. If you are going out, where am I going to pray? Do I am going to make a mistake? Do I have an arrangement for the prayer? So the prayer becomes something that I always revolve around it. So that I know my times for the prayer, I have to take the pause for that for them. The third, he said, نَقْلُ الْأَقْدَامِ إِلَى الْجَمَعَاتِ. That there is any gathering for janazah prayer, for jama'ah prayer, for jum'ah prayer, for any function, for any deed, that you need to be there every step you take. The Prophet ﷺ says, it wipes the sin and give you a reward. These are the three that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says they will wipe our sins. Then he said, وَثَلَاثٌ دَرَجَاتٌ. And three things elevate us in paradise. First, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, الْجَنَّةُ مِئَةَ دَرَجَةٌ. Jannah, paradise, is 100 ranks. He said, مَا بَيْنَ الدَّرَجَتَيْنِ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So between one rank and the other is between the heavens and the earth. And Allah said this in the Quran, Surah Maryam. وَلَلْآخِرَةَ أَكْبَرُ دَرَجَاتٍ وَأَكْبَرُ تَفْضِيلًا. So things that elevate us in that, he said, one, إِفْشَاءُ السَّلَامِ. إِفْشَاء means you spread peace. Look at what Rasulullah said. This is something that elevates us. إِفْشَاءُ السَّلَامِ. إطعام الطعام, that you feed people who are in need. Alhamdulillah, now in Toronto, we have the largest food bank. We feed even the public food bank, actually they get from, because we spread this for people. That we spread peace among people, we spread feeding other people who are in need for us. And we get thousands of people, it's well organized. We have a group of volunteers, about almost 300 people with their computers and laptops and managing this and doing that, just for helping people. We have this food on wheels, we go for homeless people, even in public parks and so on. Our youth are doing it because we encourage them. This is one of the things the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, elevate us. Ifsha'u salam, it'aamu at'aam. And the last one is a reminder for us. He said, was-salatu bil-layli wal-nasu niyam. And the best of all is when you stand up at night by yourself and pray tahajjud prayer when nobody sees you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our ways, inshallah. May Allah make it easier for all of us, inshallah. Give us the strength, give us the faith, give us the belief, inshallah. Allahumma aghfir lil muslimin wal muslimat, mu'minin wal mu'minat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat, innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awat ya rabbal alamin. Rabbana aghfir lana wal ikhwan alladhina sabaquna bil iman wa la taj'al fi qulubina ghillan lil ladhina amanu, rabbana innaka ra'ufur rahim. Allahumma arhamna wa arham موتانا وموت المسلمين، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم عاف مبتلانا ومبتلى المسلمين، اللهم فك أسرانا وأسر المسلمين، اللهم ارحم ضعفاءنا وضعفاء المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك اللهم رحمة تهدي بها قلوبنا وتزكي بها نفوسنا وتطهر بها ألسنتنا وتردنا بها إليك ردا جميلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمنا الله وإياكم، أقم الصلاة.